In this video, we are going to learn how to create ledgers and how to enter transactions in a vouchers. In a previous video, already we have learned how to create journals for a transactions. If you know how to create journals, means how to enter transactions in a journal, and it will be easy for you to enter transactions in a vouchers. In every transactions, there will be a two accounts. Okay, because we are following double entry system of accounting, so in every transactions we need to find out the two accounts, and then after finding the accounts we need to think that accounts is coming under which golden rule. After finding the golden rule of a particular account, then we need to find out whether that account is coming under credit or else debit aspects. Okay, these everything we have learned in a previous video. Then the same which example I had took in a previous video, the same example I'm going to create ledgers, and in same transactions I'm going to create vouchers in this video. Okay, now I'm going to create one company here. Before entering or else before creating transactions, first you need to create ledgers. And here you need to select the directory. So this company I am going to save in this directory itself. So I am not going to change the directory here. So I am giving name for the company, because in my problem they have not given any name. So here I will select state. State is also important while solving the problem for GST and all. Now I have created my company. Here in a previous video already I have explained how to create groups and all. So there are some default groups, there are some user defined group, means you can create your own groups in a Tally. Now you can see here, click on accounts info, two options we can see. Groups already we have learned how to create groups and all. Click on ledgers. And if you don't know how to create groups and all, you can watch that video. Link of that video I have given in a description. You can watch from there. And click on ledgers. And here you can see single and multiple ledger. Two options we can see. Main two options we can see here. In a single ledgers, create, display, alter. These three same options we can see in a multiple ledger options. Means multiple ledgers you can create in a multiple ledger create option. And display, you can display all ledgers which we have created in this company. And alter means you can alter the ledgers here. So first I am going to solve with create ledgers with a single ledger option. So click on create here. So first I will read the transaction, then you can be able to understand what accounts or else what ledgers you need to create here. So in a while creating journals, I have explained two accounts will come here. And most of the problems, most of the transactions I have taken on a cash, because this is a first problem. So in a first problem, if you got about, means if there is a transaction about banks and all, it will become so difficult to understand. So in a first problem, I have taken on a cash transactions. Okay. So first I will read the transaction. Here, Harish started business with a cash Rs 1 lakh rupee. Okay. Harish has started means it is, this amount is called as a capital account, capital amount. So here one ledger I will create as a capital account. So if it is, if that transaction is all about started business or else opened a business, if these kind of transactions comes, then here you need to take as a capital account. So here I am creating as a capital account. So here one group you can see here, capital account. Always this capital account ledger should come under capital account group here. So I am going to select capital account here, take enter and accept the changes. Next one is what? Next transaction is what was? Business received Rs 30,000 for selling goods to Manohar. See, this transaction is about receiving cash from Manohar it is. Business received ₹30,000 for selling goods to Manohar. See, already in a previous video I have explained what is direct income, what is indirect income. If any income is coming for the transaction of a business, that all incomes are come under direct income. If any business is getting income from outside, means other activity rather than the business, then that all transactions you need to take as a indirect income here. So this transaction you can heard once again. Business received ₹30,000 for selling goods to Manohar. Selling goods means what? It is a transactions come under business transaction, business activity. So for this cash receiving is considered as a direct income for the business. So for this I am creating as a Manohar account, or else you can consider it as a business received, anything. It is depending on you what ledger you want to create for the transactions. So I will consider as a business received. Okay, this has to come under what? Direct income, because this transaction will come under business activity. So direct income I am taking for this. Next one is what? 5000 rupee discount received for buying of car for personal use. Here the one activity you can heard here, discount received for buying of car for personal use. It is this activity, this transaction is not related to a business here. This person is buying, owner is buying car for his personal use. So this, he is receiving discount of 5000, but this activity, this transaction is not related to business. So this income is considered as a indirect income. Okay, next one is what? Discount received. Okay, next one is what here? Indirect income. He is getting income, but this activity is not related to income. So this transaction, this account I am taking under the group of indirect income here. Okay, next one is what? Cash of 30,000 was received from Rohan here. They have not given any business related activity here. They have not given by selling the goods, by selling the stock, they have not given like that. So if they have given, then you can consider it as a direct income and like that. But they have not given any specific activity for the business here. So for this I will assume as a indirect income here. They have not given a particular activity for what purpose this business is receiving cash from Rohan here. So for this ledger I will take group as a indirect income here. Okay, cash of received, or else from Mohan account you can consider, cash receive ledger you can take, or else received cash from Mohan, anything. It is depending on you. That ledger name should be understandable for you, so that kind of ledger name you need to take here. So cash received I have taken. So this is this ledger I am considering as a indirect income here, because they have not given any particular activity for business income here. So indirect income I have taken for this ledger. Okay, next one is what? Interest received from SBI bank here. What it is, interest is receiving, interest received for from SBI bank. Okay, next one here, income is receive, interest is receiving from SBI bank. They are receiving, owner is receiving, means business is receiving interest from bank, but they have not given any specific activity that of business transaction. So this I will consider as a indirect income. Okay, interest received. Okay, here indirect income, take enter. Next one, received cash of ₹25,000 from Suman. In a previous problem you can see one more bank name it is coming. So interest received from SBI bank. So one more ledger will come in this problem. Two ledgers will come. One is interest received and one more is SBI bank. Here SBI bank I am taking. So always in every problems I have already told two transactions will come. If the transaction is coming under that transaction is contains cash, then no need to create cash ledger here. If the transaction is containing any bank names, then bank names you need to create, means ledger you need to create for bank accounts here. So bank name they have given as a SBI Bank. So SBI Bank ledger I am creating here. This bank, all bank related ledgers will come under bank accounts here. So here I am selecting group as a bank account. So take enter. Here you need to enter the bank name, particular person name. Anna Traders is coming because this is the my company name. So company name is coming. What account name that company bank account is containing, that account number you need to take. IFSC code it will ask, bank name, branch it will ask, whatever things are required for the bank passbook, that all things it will ask here. Set checkbooks, set check printing configuration, these all things it will ask here. If you want to print any check configuration, then you need to say it as a S here. While printing the things, these all things are required, whatever things are required for the printing of configuration, that all things you need to set up here. So next option is what? SBI Bank here. Address you need to write about a SBI Bank. These all things are required. So PIN, that everything you need to enter and accept it here. Okay. Next option is what here? Next transaction is received cash of rupee 25,000 from Suman here. Received cash. Here company business is receiving cash from 25,000 from Suman it is. Cash received, cash ledger I have created here. So this amount Suman, whatever amount is receiving from Suman, this amount I will add in a received cash, because already I have created ledger. So I want to add this amount in the same ledger. So if you want to divide all these transactions, you can take new ledger here. So if you want different ledgers for different transactions, that also you can do. Or else if you all received amounts you want to add in the same ledgers, then that also you can do here. So what I want to do is received cash, this ledger already I have created. So this Suman related, or Suman, whatever amount I have received from Suman, that all amounts I will add in the same ledger. So I don't create any ledger for the sixth transaction here. So I will escape it. So if you click on display here, whatever ledgers you have created, that all ledgers you can see here. And cash and profit and loss are the two extra ledgers you can see here. For every ledgers, these are the default ledgers. Okay, cash and profit and loss, these are the two default ledgers. For every company's ledgers, you can get these two options. Okay, now we are going to learn how to create vouchers on these ledgers. So go to accounting vouchers here, click on vouchers, or else you can select, press V from your keyboard to go to the accounting voucher window. So here is what payment is coming. This is the default window for every vouchers. This is the default window you will get for a payment here. So now this transaction, whatever transactions I am doing, that all transactions are of received income. So for this I need to press F6 from my keyboard to open receipt voucher window. So press F6. Here you can see receipt window, you can see here, and this number one serial number you can see, because in this company this is the first voucher I am going to enter. So number one you are getting. After some days, if you are started to, means if you are going to enter many ledgers here, this number, serial number will go on changing as per your voucher entry in the receipt voucher. Okay. Now here you can see here, account option we can see. Account we are, option is coming here. If you are, if any second party is paying for the company on cash, that cash you can select here. Okay, this almost all problems I have taken on cash, so cash I will take. And here you can see first one is what, Harish started business with a cash of Rs 1 lakh rupee. Okay, now what I need to do, capital account I need to consider here. Click on capital account. Here one more you can see, current balance is a zero here because I have not taken any cash, means in my company there is no any cash. If you have a balanced amount, or else one more thing you need to remember, if now this transaction I am going to enter now, if there is any opening balance for your company, opening balance, when you call it as a opening balance, means if your company has started since many years back, then whatever income that company has done, that will be carried in the next year as a opening balance for the company. Understanding? One more the same point I will repeat here. Consider if any companies are started since many years, whatever income that company has done in a previous year, that income is considered as a opening balance for the current year. So this company I have started as a new company, so current balance is zero here. Okay, I am going to select capital account and how much money Harish is going to start a business. Here 1 lakh rupee, from 1 lakh rupee he is going to start a business. Here 1 lakh I am going to enter now and take accept. And here you need to write the narration, means you need to write something about the transactions. Harish started business. Okay, and one more thing here date you can see, this trade you need to enter on which day this transaction is going to do, means on which day this transaction has happened. But in this tally I am using as a educational mode. I am using this transaction or this tally in a educational mode, so here I can't able to change the date here, so I am not going to change any dates here. Okay, now I have entered narration and take enter to accept the changes on this receipt. Now you can see here receipt number 2 it is coming. So now second transaction I will read. Business received ₹30,000 for selling goods to Manohar. This what account I have taken, business received ledger I have created for this transaction. So here is what, cash only he is receiving, he is not receiving by any banks here, so cash I am going to select here. Okay, now is what, cash, next transaction ledger is what, business received transaction I had took on. Okay, how much amount of business has received transaction, 30,000 it had received, so 30,000 I will write. And if you want, you can write next transaction here itself. So I will show how you can do. This transaction was on cash, so if you want to write any transaction on the same cash account, then you can write next after this transaction here itself. So next transaction is what, discount received, discount 5000 discount received for buying of car for personal use. So here only I am going to write discount received. So how much here discount he has received, 5000 he has received, so 5000 I am going to write here. And next transaction is was cash of 30,000 was received from Rohan here, so cash he is going to receive. So on same receipt voucher I am going to do here, cash of 30,000 received from Rohan here. So what ledger I had took for this, cash received I had took, so cash received here is what, 30,000 he had received. So take enter. Next transaction is what, interest received from SBI bank. So this transaction I can't able to enter here because interest is receiving from SBI bank. Here I have account I have taken as a cash, so this transaction you can't enter for the cash account here. So this transaction I need to enter in a new receipt here. So now I will accept this. Whatever transaction narration you want to write, that you can write here. You need to write the narration depending on the voucher on what transaction you have created here. Okay, take enter and accept it. Next one is what, interest received from SBI bank. So here I am going to write SBI, select SBI bank as a accounts. So here bank current balance is zero here. If there is any cash in a SBI bank, then that amount will be displayed in a current balance option here. So there is no amount in my SBI bank, so it is coming as a zero here. Now I need to select ledger here, on which ledger you want to enter this amount, and here you need to select as a here you need to enter the amount for the transactions. So now you can see here current balance is considering as a 5000 rupee. So whatever interest has been received, that it is going to the bank here. Okay, that amount is going to bank because bank has received this from, he has received amount from bank. So it will, amount will directly go to the bank, and if that owner wants this amount, then he need to withdraw from this SBI bank. This transaction is like this. If you consider this transaction into reality, then you need to consider it as just I explained. Okay, here you need to enter the check number and all, because that amount is receiving for the bank, so there is no any check details here. So enter and accept it. Received cash of rupee 25,000 from Suman. For this, the same ledger I have taken, cash is receiving, so cash you need to select as an account here. And then here, received cash, cash received transaction means ledger I have to, then select cash receive here, and then enter the amount as a 25,000, accept it. And narration is received from Suman, means you can understand here what transaction had happened and what, with whom this transaction has happened. If you write the transaction in a narration, it is able, you can be able to understand the transaction properly. So all my transactions has done. So now I will accept it. Now we can go to balance sheet, or else you can go to profit and loss to find out the profit and loss of your company. Click on profit and loss. Press Alt F1 to elaborate the profit and loss. Here you can see net profit, you can see at the left side net profit you can see, and next one is what, right side, gross profit you can see here. Okay, gross profit at the right side. Indirect income means whatever indirect incomes you have taken as a group for the transaction ledgers, that all will be grouped in a indirect income. Then direct income group will be displayed in one separate group here. This is separate group and this is separate group. All ledgers will be placed in a same as per the specific groups we have taken while creating the ledgers. Your business receipt 30,000. This all three ledgers you can see at the one side. And cash received, it is only one ledger you can see, but I had created six ledgers, vouchers I had entered. But here you can see discount received is a separate, interest received is a separate. But two vouchers I had entered in a, two transactions I had entered in under the cash received ledger. So that all amount is adding into the same receipt voucher here. See, this is the receipt 30,000 and this is the 25,000. These both vouchers are adding into the same ledger here. Okay. I hope you all have understood. Net profit is 95,000 you can see here, and gross profit is what, 30,000. By including all these indirect income and direct income, you can see at the left side net in a group of net profit. Thanks for watching my video. I hope you all have understood how to create ledgers and how to enter the ledgers transactions in a vouchers. And then don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel.